Hello guys, welcome to the Slay Club. You already know it's your girl, Bree Jamila. If you're here for the first time, it's about time. It took you long enough. I'm just kidding. Welcome to my channel. I hope that you have watched all my other videos and you are going to enjoy this video today. If you're a subscriber, welcome back to my channel. You know I miss you guys. I hope you had a wonderful and productive week. It's October. I know, right? That was like so fast. 2020 is already over. But let's get right into this video. Today, I will be doing a Get Ready With Me date night edition. So you guys will be seeing me do a little quick makeup tutorial on my face. That's why I look a mess. And you will also be seeing me put some fits together that you can wear in a date night. And all of these fits are affordable, guys. You guys know I love a bargain. I'm your girl of a bargain. But I'm gonna get y'all ready. So when y'all bae till y'all is date night and y'all ready to go, I got three fits for y'all. One casual, one extra dressy, and one a little, you know, in between. So I just want you guys to really enjoy this video, but let's get into it. I did my brows off camera. Wow. My brows take way too long. I'm not gonna hold y'all. Y'all just don't want it. Y'all don't want to wait to see me do this. So I did it off camera. And the items that I used to do my brows were, my pomade is Music Flower. Hope you guys can see that. Music Flower. It's in brown. You can get it off Amazon. You go on the actual website, your choice. And what I use on my top and my bottom. Yes, I use two different colors. Some people use the same color, but I use two different colors. For the bottom lid, I use Deep Olive. It's from e.l.f. It's a 16-hour cameo. And I use for the top, Deep Chestnut. And just for me, it just works better, especially when I'm putting my foundation on. I always recommend, guys, start out with the spoolie and with the spoolie. So before you even do the pomade, brush out your brows, because that's why a lot of people's brows be looking wild. Brush your brows out. After you brush them out, put your pomade on, then brush it out again. Trust me, it gives it a better look. And I've noticed that as I've kept doing it. Now, I learned this method on TikTok when it comes to applying your foundation. Now, I'm weird because I put on my foundation before I put on my eyeshadow. I will not be doing no crazy eyeshadow today. I know usually my videos, my eyeshadow be, but today, no crazy eyeshadow. Because my looks, trust me, guys, it takes way too long. Maybe I'll do a video in the future of me literally doing step by step by step. But we just trying to get cute and get to the fits. Now, what I learned this method off of TikTok. We love TikTok. And basically, you would moisturize first, which I already done. And you're gonna take your setting powder. So I use the Shasha Buttercup. To me, for darker skin tones, this is the holy grail. If you don't know, now you know. So I just take a brush, not too big, not too small, and I dip it in the setting powder, just a little, you don't do a lot, and you lightly brush it across your face. So you just lightly brush it across your face. Guys, how are you doing? You guys need to let me know what kind of videos you guys want to start seeing, because I'm just going off the whim here and making my videos, but y'all gotta give me some ideas y'all want to see. I know you guys want to see the luxury bag one. It's coming. Just give me a second. It's coming. But I don't know what else you guys want to see. Like, you know, you gotta give me a heads up. Anyway, so just lightly, I got the setting powder on my face. You know, not too much, not too little, just a right amount. Then after that, you're going to take your setting spray. Me, I love Morphe. Morphe, I don't know what it's pronounced as, but this setting spray, another holy grail. So you're gonna take this. And yes, I'm one of those people, I overuse setting spray. Just gonna fan it out a little bit. I want to dry just a little before I do my next step. I know I'm bored, guys. I'm a mess. Anyway, 2020, guys. Are you guys, can't believe it's already October? This is wild. Anyway, for the next step, we will be putting on a primer. This is from NYX Photo Loving Primer. For all the people that stay in my DMs asking me why my pictures look so good. Sorry, I had an ADD moment. This is why they look so good. This primer, it's it, you know? It's definitely it. Just get it everywhere. Rub it in, guys, rub it in. There you go, rub it in. Okay, doc. Now that we're done with that part, you add your foundation. Now I'm a little weird, guys. My foundation usually like three foundations mixed in one. Why? I don't know. I feel like I can never find my exact shade on what my face is, if that makes any sense. So I use the Matchmaster from MAC. Obviously, MAC, you can see it's completely dirty because this, I love it. And I use Juvia's Place. And this is in the shade of, I don't even know. Anyway, I don't even know. All I know is I Am Magic Velvety Matte Foundation. Listen, I'll link it below so you guys can see what I bought. Oh, there it goes. It's called Kampala 340. Ha ha. It's on the back. Ha ha. Took me long enough. And the Studio Fix, this is in 9.0. So I think I got one of the darkest ones. So I mix my foundation. Usually, I'm a weirdo. I put three pumps on my hand. Yes, I mix my foundation on my hand. I am that person. And then I do a pump. Then all I do is take the bottom of any brush and I just stir it together. Stir it together, guys. And then once you do that, because I'm cheap and you already know that, I just go like this. I don't got time to beg these YouTubers and wasted makeup. No, I'm not. Yes, I am wiping it off just like this. Anybody who knows me knows this is exactly how I put my makeup on. Why do I do this? Because I am not wasting anything that's on this brush. Makeup is not cheap. Ooh, got on my thing. Anyway. Now, beauty blender. We love a beauty blender. Now, it's already wet, as you guys can see. Now, I'm just going to go in. I'm gonna dab it up, guys. Now you're gonna watch me become a different color. And we just pound it in, guys. Pound it in. I do it over my lips too, because I want my lips to become very mattish looking. So that it looks really good when I put on my lipstick. Also, I'm weird, and you guys can say this, but I actually dab my whole eye. I close my whole eye and dab it. Why do I do that? I don't know. It's just something that I've always been comfortable with. And no, it is not the right way to apply makeup, but it's just what works for me. Okay, so I want you guys to understand that this tutorial is literally what works for Brittany. Okay? So, don't judge. This is just my way of putting on my makeup. Because my way, right? I got a little bit of concealer on the, a little bit of foundation on the brow. We don't want that. So we get the neck, guys. Guys, get the neck. I be looking at some of y'all pictures on IG and y'all don't be getting the neck. Your neck need to match your face. I don't care if you want to be brown in the face. Make your face and you dark. Make your neck and your face match. We can see it. It looks weird. Anyway, I do my ears too. Yes, I do that. I even put makeup on my ears because I want everything to blend. Everything. I'm getting makeup all over my wicked. Anyway. By the way, this is like my favorite bonnet. It does not come off at nighttime, which I love. But yeah, guys. Now y'all see that blend? Do y'all see that blend? Do y'all see that? Do you see it? Now y'all see why I mix my makeup, right? Because it just snatches the face. It snatches. But anyway, so with that being said, now that we got our makeup on, girl, what I like to do is I go in, and no, I do not wipe this off. I always keep this on my hand until the end because sometimes you have to go back in, you know, and get it right. Now, not this first. We're going to put on a little bit of eyeshadow, nothing crazy because I'm not doing no crazy look today, but we're going to use the Kylie Jenner, the new Sailor palette. I actually really like this palette. It is bomb.com. She literally ate when she made this. I think I wanted to like something neutral since I already have the fits picked out. So something definitely neutral. I think I'm going to use Tidal Wave, which is that one. And I always tap, swipe and tap. I don't want nothing crazy today. Just a little light look. Very nudish. Nothing crazy at all, guys. Let me switch out the brush. I actually don't like that brush. Something very light because the fits that I have, obviously, it's very neutral. So I want a neutral color on the lid. And I always recommend that, guys. If you're going to do certain color fits, I'm sorry, I be having ADD, guys. If you're going to have certain color fits, you need to have a neutral look. Some of y'all looks, you see that? Just really light. Like a nice, it's like a mauve, if that's the correct color I'm using, I'm thinking of. It's like a mauve. Very, very clean, you know? You guys are going to see how dope this look is going to look in the end. It's just very clean. I love a clean look. I know a lot of times you guys come on here and you see me with the pink eyeshadows, the, you know, the craziness. But today, I didn't want to give that. I wanted to give like a cute vibe. Because sometimes those looks, guys, I'm not going to hold y'all. I literally be in the mirror for about an hour trying to create these looks for these YouTube videos. But you guys are worth it. You're worth everything. Like, you're worth the looks. You're worth it. And I love you guys. So, you know, I'm going to do it for y'all. But I get so many DMs about my looks, about what palettes I use. And I'm a big fan of Juvia's Place. As you can see, I use a lot of Juvia's Place. And I use a lot of, who else? Juvia's Place. I love Morphe, whatever you call them. I love their palettes. I just feel like they have, it's very pigmented and it just does what you need it to do. Because it's so like light, I decided I probably want to go over it with Captain Cutie. The names for this palette is hilarious, but Captain Cutie, which is that one, you guys probably can't see it. You can't. But anyway, Captain Cutie. It's a light, like, sparkly pink. But I'm just going to tap it over. Because we're doing a date night, right? So we want a little, For date night, we want a little, it's date night. You know, you could be cute for bae. All right. So we're getting it together, guys. I don't know. For some odd reason, I don't know why this keeps coming in my spirit to talk about it. But since we're here, let's get into it. Lately, I've been realizing, and I don't know if it's just me. Y'all gotta tell me in the comments. You know when you ever tell your friend about something, and it's like, you tell them that you're gonna do something, right? And it's like, they with it in the beginning. But as soon as they be like, you serious about what you about to do, and like, you making moves, do you not ever realize they start acting mad, like, oh, you shouldn't do that, or I don't think that's a good idea, or, and not just be sending them looking at like, what's good for you is good for you, and what's good for me is good for me. I understand sometimes friends want to give you their opinion, but sometimes I be feeling that hating spirit in the end, and I just be like, I don't know. Like, I'm real cautious on how I tell people things and if I tell people things. I'm real cautious lately because I realize people, they don't be for you. Like, and that would be the scariest thing ever. People do not be for you. And I'm just like, it's a no for me, dog. But anyway. Anyway, we got the sparkle all over. You guys can see it. I got sparkle all over. I actually brought it up more because I have a very wide lid. So I brought it up more. And when I usually bring it up like that, I usually try to just go in some of the corners that the glitter spilled and just kind of wipe it out with the foundation. My method, guys, please understand that. It works for me. So that's what I do. I do what works for me. Now that I got just a little glitter, nothing crazy. Because remember, we don't want it to mess up our fit. Now I'm going to take Wet n Wild. We love Wet n Wild products. Y'all probably can't even see that. But this is a Wet n Wild Mega Liner. Only eyeliner I actually use. Other than, I think Estee Lauder. Estee Lauder is the only other one I use. So guys, I'm gonna be quiet because this takes patience. Y'all see that? Oof. Y'all not ready for that wing. Y'all wasn't ready for that wing. That wing ate y'all up, didn't it? It ate y'all up. That wing ate y'all up. You know what's so funny, guys? I really hate eyeliner. I really do. Like, anybody who knows me, it's very rare to see me in eyeliner. Because I just hate the concept of it. We gotta get that. Gotta get that. Fergie, get it? Gotta get that. Black Eyed Peas. I'm weird. I think I messed up that one a little bit, but you know how we fix that? Cause you know, I'm a genius. So let me show y'all how I fix it. Now y'all see why I keep this under my hand, right? So I just take a little bit on the brush that I actually used to do my, and then you just go in there. Yep. Works like a charm every time. Every time. I'm weird, guys. You guys gotta understand that. Look at that. Shall we fix that right quick? Fix that up, guys. And if you want, what I usually do, take the brush that I was putting eyeshadow on with and just dab it in case you're scared that it rubbed off. There you go. There you go. Now, I don't wipe the thing on my hand. We about to put some black eyeliner under here, guys. I decided to put on my, what is it called? Eyeliner, I guess? I don't know. Anyway, I use Urban Decay. It's called 24/7 Glide Eye Pencil. So I use it to go underneath. I put my lashes on. My lashes are from the Be Supply store. I mean, not like Be Supply store lashes. I actually already put on my concealer to lighten up my face a bit. Now I'm going to add on my lipstick, guys. My lipstick and my highlighter. My highlighter is from Avalon. It is super old. It's called Super Shock Chic. It's old. Like, I've had this for years. As you can see, it looks a mess. But when you put this bad boy on, it be bussin'. Yes. Oh, bright is my future, guys. As bright as my future. Whoa, y'all felt that? That hit different. That hits different. I only use this when I actually am going on a date, though. I don't ever use it for no other reason. I have other highlighters that I use, but this one. Rihanna who? Nah, I'm playing. I got trophy wife too. I love me some Riri. Right there. Oh my God. It's bussing. And then I just literally just do a little bit on my nose. Guys, I do not highlight. I do not contour. My face is already very strong. My features are real, you know? So I don't contour. If you usually see me contour, it's very rare because just no. Anyway, so I put a little bit above my lip. Got my lip shining and we shining. Y'all should see me when I'm doing my makeup alone. I'll be in here bumping with the music on. I should have put music on. That's what I should have did, but I'll stand there here and right there. Now for the lippy time. I outline my lip with the new Kylie Jenner lip pencil from her Sailor collection. Guys, anytime I do my lip, I outline my lip. Not because I don't have any lips. I just choose to outline. So guys, I decided to change my lip liner because I wasn't feeling that one for the color lip that I wanted to do. So instead, I changed it to this thing called Anico. This is actually not available in the US. It's from the Jamaica West Indies. Every time I go to Jamaica, I always bring it back. But this, holy girl. So I just line my lips as much as possible, as you can see. You see that? My allergies is on 10. Hate when the weather changes. You see that? I got some good lips. Mad right now. Anyway, anywho. Guys, I hope you guys are over there treating yourselves good, living it up. I know it's a pandemic, but you guys are really taking care of yourselves. I got this. This is a lip that I want to use. It's the e.l.f. Matte Lip Liquid Lipstick. Now, I just go on the inner crease from the inside. See, you did here, now you're going to go in. What do you guys think? Now, to finish it off and give it that Barbie look, which we love, Beauty Supply lip gloss. Ooh. Oh God. I'm not even gonna edit that out. I'm gonna leave it. Cause girl, y'all know the struggle of putting makeup on. Now, take it, just it in, take a brush. I literally pat it in, if that makes any sense. And if you notice, I don't put the lip gloss anywhere near the liner, because I want to keep that. Yeah, it's gonna look. I'm loving this look. I'm loving it. It's cute. It's, you know, it's get ready with me. Now, we're going to put this wig on. Yeah, I know. If you haven't already, please follow at the underscore slave club. It is here. Please follow that page so I can slay y'all wig and get y'all right. Ooh, yes, honey. Look at this. Is this queen? Look at how she looking. I'm gonna get this right. Yeah. Now, this is a wig that I made out of a closure, which is wild. Now, I'm gonna pull up a little bit. I don't want my eyebrows showing, obviously, but I do want my lashes to show. Now, the reason I did my brows, even though I know I got bangs, is because I'm going to be switching into another wig, a longer wig. So I'm just going to fly iron this, give it a little bit of oomph, because I don't want it to be flat. I'm going to give it like a full juh. No Jasmine Masters. Juh. My sister put me onto that word. I love Jasmine Masters, but anyway. We gonna get this wig together. Guys, y'all know. Ooh, messing my lip. I love this look. Don't y'all love it? I love it. Yeah, I did my makeup on camera. Just had a tongue twister just now. I did my makeup on camera. Y'all should be so proud of me. Like, guys, y'all gotta ask my sister. When I do my makeup, it takes me like 10 years. I'm not going to hold y'all. Like, I am the slowest person to get ready with. It's not even funny. Like, I'm the type of person, you gotta tell me like 4 or 5 hours in advance. Like, yo, you wanna go out later? Like, you gotta tell me in advance. Cause I'm that person. It takes me that long. See, I don't have it all the way on. Because I pulled it back. Because I don't want the wig all the way down. Because I didn't want to cut the bangs that low. So I kind of just pull it back for my liking. Like, I can pull it all the way down. But I wanted the bangs to look a certain way. So I kind of just bootlegged it because it's my hair. But And I honestly, to stop me from breaking out so much, I did it this way. So. Who's that girl? La, 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 la. I'm that girl. All right, I'm done being ghetto fab. So there's a hair in my eye and it's blinding me. Just making sure I'm not blinding myself, but anyway. There you go, guys. Now, to get, you see how that bob is straight? Y'all felt that? Y'all feeling that? Look at that. You see how it's straight? Say less. Anyway, to get it that straight, bam. You see these two mixed together? Y'all not ready. Look. Y'all not ready. This alone is like $30. In the stores, it's like 40 something, but I bought off Amazon. This I bought off Amazon, it was like $6. But this, it's worth it though. You can use it in your wigs and you can use it in your natural hair. So I'm just gonna brush a little bit. I'm really loving my lip like so much. And of course I'm gonna go back over it. All right, guys, time for fit number uno. Let's get into it.
Okay, so this is look number one. You see, shoes are always fire. Purse matches the shirt and the earrings. It's all about details, honey, details. So this is something if you just wanna be really just sexy, but you know, you're giving babe a vibe here. You let him know that you is still that chick and you is gonna be that chick and that's on period, right? Love this fit. I really do love this fit. God, I just do this together and I'm really loving this. And I chose these shoes because the chain in this shirt actually is the same iridescence in the shoe. I really love this. I really love this fit. I love these pants with the cutout on the side. It's giving me a vibe. Giving me a vibe. Okay, now this fit is for my more, I would say, casual girls who are not definitely not feeling the other two fits. Something sexy, but at the same time, giving you real sexy vibes, you know? Nice nude strap pump, cute little pochette, you know? Just giving the straight, girly, but still sexy vibes. Cause I know not everybody has the same sense of style I do. So I feel like this is something anybody could wear. Whether you're very dressy like me, or you like to keep it simple yet cute. And you see how I gave like a turtleneck? You know? It gives it a good vibe for the, so you could do that in the fall, the winter. You could throw a nice little leather jacket over this and eat this look up. Definitely feeling this look. Now this is the last look. This would be if babe was on some yo, be going to the movies, throw some quick on. You know me, pair of sweats. You know, custom Air Force Ones. They actually match my bag. Cause y'all know I'm about that life. If you follow me on IG, I tagged the designer when I wore these, so you can cop a pair for yourself, but because they're customs, But yeah, this is a cute little fit. If Bae was like, yo, we going to the movies. You know, just something normal. Nothing crazy. I like this fit. I will be doing a tutorial on this bag because this is one of my favorite bags, but you get the drift. Guys, again, thank you for stopping at my channel. If you haven't already, please go like, comment, subscribe, and share. Watch my other videos. And don't forget to follow me at @_SlayClub and my personal page, Bree_Jamila. They will be in the description box below.